Okay, administrative tool services. Okay, then you can see they are in the Microsoft SQL Server. Okay, sorry, SQL Server. Then you can see they are SQL. Okay, SQL Server Express. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can you follow? Yes, SQL Server Express. Then right click there. Okay, that's a go to the properties. Okay, this is the automatically sign. You can change automatic start. When you boot your computer, it is automatic start. Because that if sometimes they are not setting there is the manual, they are in the manual or disabled there. Because if you install every time to start your server, still your computer performance reduced. Okay. Therefore, they had that three setting. Okay. If you, when you boot up your computer, is the automatic mean when you open that boot your computer, server also starting run. Manual mean when you need for the server, then you can start run the server. Okay. Disable mean you stop. Here is a, we had a stop and pause also there. If you have, we have any edit something, then we had to pause that thing and that's like, okay, now we can do that. Now you can use that the automatic and apply. Okay, like then now you can open. Okay, another things, we have the two access mode, administrative active window mode and user mode also. Then usually I in here in our laboratory, we are using both the window authentication mode, because if you use it, one students are set the particular password or something, change the password, then other person cannot use it. Therefore, we are running in the window application mode. Okay. Okay, I will explain everything today. How many students are there? 32. Okay, in the 2008, they had this window administrator. Wait, sorry. Because of 2008, configuration is not there. Installed. Wait. There's a configuration. Download. Viewer. Vshot. Okay, so then I want to rejoin again. I want to terminate because I wanted another account also. Okay. Please rejoin again. Introduction to the database. Already you study for the database. Now we refresh that one. Okay. The database is the organized collection of the information. You want to properly organize the information. Therefore, you can access the database any without any error. Therefore, we need for the database easy to handle. A relational database is a collection of related information that has been organized into the structure known as a table. Okay, any information you are keeping in the table. Each table contains rows are further organized into the column. Then we use that the in table, the column, we call this a field. In other words, you can call for the entity. Table is the attribute. Table is the entity. Table is the entity, but the column is the attributes or field. But in the table, we call for the, that entity is called as a table, and inside that column is the attributes. Okay, each rows. Okay. You should already familiar with the information belong represent in the okay the form of table with the column. Okay, each column has a field and rows has the information about for the particular entity. Now we come for the list the product ID, name, quantity. Okay, quantity per unit and unit price for the first 10 product in the product table of the Northwind database. Now want to go there in the database, you want to open the database, you can go to the start SQL Server Management Studio. Okay. Okay. Then this is the server name. Give the authentication as a window authentication mode. Okay. Then you can change for the server name and user. Okay, not in the window only. If you install the database in your computer, okay, then it as take for the window authentication as a password as a when you open your computer. Okay, boot up the computer, you give the your password, then it take for the window authentication mode. Then if you not necessary, then you can use that other mode, it's called server authentication. Then you can give the login. Who are the many user you can assign? Login and give the password. Give the password. But in our computer, in our lab, we are using places in that computer. If you set the password and something, that's the problem. Therefore, we are using for the window authentication mode. Window authentication mode. Then connect. Okay. This is the object explorer. This is the object explorer. Okay. This is the database. Okay, then it has a default one. If you install, only you have this one. Okay, system database has a master model MSDB and temdb. This is the default list there, but other one, if you create new one, they are so here. Okay, then already I upload that database also. Then you download it. It is okay. You download it. Then you can attach that database. Okay, you select this here. Okay, you select this database and attach. Okay, then you ask for the add. Okay, then where is your database? I already upload that database, you download for the Northwind. Then you can select. Okay, then but I put that database. Usually that if you install your database, SQL Server Management Studio. Okay, then you can go that usually that installation in the C drive. Okay, you can see there. Okay, C drive and program files. Okay, the two is there. I think here is a program file 86. Then you can see SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server. Here, Microsoft SQL Server. Okay, then we have 100, I think. Okay, Microsoft in the program file. Okay, because this is a 64-bit. Previous I installed for the 32-bit. Okay, then this is the local disk, program file, Microsoft SQL Server. Here is a Microsoft SQL Server 11 SQL Server Express. Open that one. Again open. Then you can use here is a, if you create the database, it's in under the data folder. If you create here also any database. Okay, any database here, it is under that data folder. Okay, you can see this is a return SQL Server Express, that is the name of the server. Okay, everything under the data server. Then you can copy for the two files. One is a NodeWin LDF and NodeWin MDF. Log file also there, and both file we need. Okay, first you copy that one. Or anywhere you can copy it, don't worry about. But both file is need. One is the log file, other one is the database file. Because the log file has the detail of your database. That also need for the server. Then you, okay. Anywhere you can say, then you can select where your file, and you can select in the data. I saw here this one, and select and okay, attach. You want to attach your file. Then after that, you can use it the database in your server. Okay, again, I will explain. Already you copy that your file. Okay, select the database, right click. Attach. Okay, you can minimize. Okay, you can half of the window. You can use my presentation, and after half of the window, you can open that one and use it. Okay, attach, and you click add. Then you had to select the that database name of the database and okay. Okay, already is there, therefore I cannot attach again. That's the problem. Already that database in my server, then cannot make for the duplicate, therefore is a problem for here. But already is there, is you cannot attach the same name. If you different name, you can attach. Okay, then okay, like you can attach now. I think everyone is attached. Can you attach the database?
Yes.
Again, I explain database, right click, attach. Okay, then add. Where's your database? You location you had is select, because this is the reformat under the C. I put it in the proper folder, because everything, if you install the data, sorry, SQL Server Management Studio, it is under that program files. Okay, in the C location, local disk, under program files, then you go to the SQL Server, Microsoft SQL Server, and Microsoft SQL Server 11 SQL Express, or sometime you have the above version, then you can check the name of the server, because here the server name is the SQL Express. Then therefore you can find that there is a, usually our, if you create here any database under that data folder, therefore I put the same places. You can put the any other places, or you can select that place. and OK. Then you you can see that the Northwind database. You can see here Northwind, that's a data diagram, tables, view, and programmability, server, service broker, a lot of stuff there. Okay, in the tables, we have some tables are here. Now we can go to that presentation. Start all program, Microsoft SQL Server 2012. Okay, select new query and write down this query here. Okay, you want to write down the query. First, you want to access some data. Okay, some data want to retrieve from data from database. That's the way here. Already you study in the SQL language also. Therefore, I not too much spending for this is a select asterisk mark mean all attributes from product table where product ID less than 10. Then we want to first 10 record want to display, want to get, okay, want to retrieve from the database, which in the database, particular table, product table. Okay, then you go to the attachment, okay. Great. That is here, new queries, click. Then you can write. Okay, SQL, right. Then use, what is the name of the database? Northwind. You can see here, we are going to use for the Northwind because in here, we have, I have four, three database. The computer doesn't know my table is where is there. Then we want to point out which database we want to use. Then you can type the use database name as the Northwind. Okay, Northwind. Okay, you can terminate, then you can use that semicolon and second one. Now want to write that this query, select asterisk from product where product ID less than or equal 100. Then I want to explain. I open that table because we want to give the specific name of the attribute and table name also. Because the SQL is the case sensitive, only for the object, not in the command. Now, Okay, for example, to open the service, you select the Start Control Panel Administrative Tools. Okay, therefore, in the services, you can see the SQL Server, right click and start and stop. For example, our universities only function for the morning 8:30 to 4:30 or 5. After that, we can stop our server because not necessary to run. Then you can start. One person want to then start. Or we can give the command also later. We'll study what are the command we can give for write the SQL statement and run the Java server. Everything we can programmatically also we can run. But we want to put there, sir. Morning we want to start for the 8:30 and 5 o'clock we want to stop. After not necessary to run for the server. Then again tomorrow that like only Saturday, Sunday. If you not person is use that server, then you can set that only 5 days on the run. After that, not necessary. Then you can start and stop SQL server. You use the service. Okay. To open the service. Okay. Then you can select the okay. Start control panel, administrative tools in the services. There is the SQL server, right click and start and stop. If you start this server, then you can open the Microsoft SQL Management Studio and edit your, create your thing. Okay, now there is the, some folders are there in the database, some folder. Database, you can access. Okay, contain tool that allow you to access the database managed by SQL Server. Data transformation services. What is that? Data transformation. They provide the access to tool that allow you to move data from one database to another. You can also programmatically modify the data as it is moved. For example, sorry. Okay, you might want to make data from SQL Server database and Oracle, okay, other database also you can import and thing. Then after the other one is a manage. Contain tool that allow you to backup your database, monitor current database activity and other tasks also in the management folder. Okay, replication. Provide the access tool that allow you to copy information from one database to another in near real time using process known as the database programming. Okay, database. Security. Okay, contain tool that allow you to manage the login and built-in role that contain the permission. Okay, you can give the security. Okay, particular person can access the database. Particular person can access the part of the database, everything in the security. Then we'll study later also how to give that permission also. Support services provide the access to tool that allow you to manage the distributed transaction coordinator. Okay, allow you to manage the transaction that use more than one database. Full text search, that thing you can either support services, okay, in the SQL Server mail, everything. Next is the metadata. This is the contain tool that allow you to manage the information stored in the local repository. This information contains the detail about the database, user, table, column, everything in the metadata. Okay, metadata, I mean the detail about the data. Detail about the data. That's the metadata. The data. That also you can use the store procedure. Everything we are going to study in here also. Because you already study in the last semester only basic SQL command. Basic SQL command, not in the other thing, function. Everything we are going to study, function, store procedure, cursor, everything in this semester. Okay, close to look at the database folder. Okay, diagram, table, view, store procedure, user, role, rules, default, and user defined data type, user defined function, full text catalog. Okay, you can see there in the okay, already we have the database, security, server object, replication, management. Okay, in the security, we have some login, server role, key, and everything. Now you can see the server object, backup device, link server, trigger, everything. We can use a later also trigger, what is a trigger, something like. Okay, local submission. This is the management. Policy and SQL locks who are locking this server, everything details are here. Now it's a database. They have a system database master. They has a view, synchronized, programmatically, service broker, storage. Okay, this is the programmatically we can have the store process. Okay, everything you create the procedure, it is store here. Okay, so procedure. We will study later also. Just I explain, these folders are under that system database, under the master and program. We can have some function. Okay, system already building function also there. You also can create the function, table value function, user can. Create that there is no function in there. We are going to create, then we can show in the what is the functions are there. Own function also we can create some calculation. I want to do it, then here we can do it. Now create system function. You already this software group already created system function. Okay, you already some function is there. So some average. Scalar value function. That's it. Okay, system functions are there. Okay, later we study for the that system function also. What other function is available for the system already has some ready-made function. That function also you can use. Okay, under that function that. Okay, we will study for the what are the system function and table, what are the function in later also. Then these are the function, store procedure, data, trigger. That also we are going to study in the trigger also. We are not create anything. Then type roles, default, sequence, service. Then you can see that things here for database. That close the database folder, we have this function. Okay, folders are there, diagram. Visual represent on the table in the database. Okay, the diagram means you can use that to create the ERD diagram. Entity relationship diagram. Give the relationship for each other tables and do it. Tables, the data store in the table. Views, we want to create that view. User, a view the retrieve a set of column from one or more table. Okay, sometime the user won't need the different view. Okay, to join to tables and particular attribute won't need to display. Then we want to create the views. Okay, then we can create the many views. Okay, now in second one is the store procedure. Some function or some tasks won't execute again. Then we use for the store procedure. For example, want to insert the form view is there. You have a record, want to insert. Then you can call again. That's store procedure. And sometime end of the day, want to backup. Then we can write for the store procedure. That particular time, want to backup. Execute that. then you can stop right there. Otherwise, you want every day, you want to write the statement and run it. But some statement again want to talk, want to again execute, then you can use for the stop. Then user, who are use log into the database using the valid account. That details. Then role, name, set of the permission that you can assign to the a user. What's the role they are, have the permission, which level, what's they are. Okay, then rules. An expression that evaluate to either true or false. Okay, value of the column. Okay, value the value to a column replaced by the constraint. Everything in the rules. Defaults. Okay, an initial value that is set of the where you added. You added when. You added the new row, everything, that is the default. User, define data type. Create the own type, everything. User, define function. Okay, user can define the own function. That also, you can keep it and see that.
Record
full text catalog. Full text catalog. Then we add that. Catalog of the thing. Then we it is as in the database folder. Default user. We have the two type of users are there. Two default user name. One is DBO. Who are the owner of that database? Okay. That is the user as a DBO user. DBO user own the database and has the permission to do anything in the database. Okay. Okay. Then check, create new table, edit everything. The user, the default user can do anything. They have the permission. He has a permission to do anything. Guest. The guest user has more limited permission than you can allow. For example, now the student, you want to access some database. Okay. For example, you have the email, then you can change your password something, but you cannot change your user ID. Okay, only particular owner, that's who is the Yahoo mail or Gmail, that person can change your ID. Okay, user name, that's a user name ID. That's the permission. That's the permission is there, but you are the guest or guest user, give some allow to some permission, access the content of the table, but not able to create and edit the table. That's the thing. Particular person can edit the table. That's the two type of users are there. DB is the owner of the database and other one is a guest. Okay, the permission grant to user. Then you can give the permission for each table you can set. Not in the database. Table also you can give the permission. Select. Insert, update, delete, execute, right. For example, now you have the online banking system also. Okay, you can withdraw the transfer the money or something, but you cannot edit in your transaction. You cannot, after that, you cannot edit your transaction. You can deduct your money and send the other account, something that is possible, but okay, that's the we will want to give for something. Select, insert, update, delete, execute, derive. These are the some permission you can give, the grant permission. Okay, then you can grant the permission also. part two, that is exploring the Northwind database. If the database may have many tables, some of which are related to each other. Okay, then I already in the diagram folders are there. You can create your ER diagram. For example, Northwind database contains many tables for which are name, customer, order, order detail, and product. You want to create that relationship with the four tables. Okay, then you can go the database diagram. It is the relationship there. You can see here, this is the product. There's a product ID is the primary key. There's a key is there. Then order detail. Then order detail has the order ID and primary keys. This is the foreign key for product ID in here. Then you can connect, relate for one table to another table. Order detail to order and customer ID. Here is the foreign key of the customer ID. But in here is the order ID and product ID is the both the primary keys, because one customer can make many order. One order have many products. Is it okay? One order has many products. Therefore, we use here order ID and product ID more the primary keys, order details. One order have many products. Okay, the one customer has one order. Or many order also they can make, but the order, one order has many products. Then the product ID details are there. Okay, typically each table in a database has one or more columns that uniquely identify each row in the table. Therefore, we are using the primary key. For example, you register here, then we use the primary key as your registration number. Okay, some places are used for the your registration number, your things as your ID. Okay, if you got that telephone connection, no telephone SIM card, then they are using your ID and number is a primary key. Because one person has many SIM. One person has many SIM. Therefore, they are using both. Same for the bank also, you can create the many account. Current account, saving account, fixed account. Therefore, they are using for the account number and your identity card number is the primary key. Okay. You should identify the each record. Therefore, we use for uniquely identify each record, we use the primary key. Okay. Then this column is known as the primary key for the table. A primary key can be composed for more than one column also. You can set the many keys. Okay, many column for the primary keys, not one. In such case, is known as a composite key. We call this a composite key. Example, in the case of the customer table, the primary key is the customer ID. Okay, the primary key for the order table, order is the order ID is the primary key. But the primary keys of the order detail table, they have a composite, okay, composed of the two column, order ID and product ID. Because one order has a many product. Therefore, we keep it that both the primary key. That's why we call this a composite key. The primary key for the product table is the product ID. Then one more column also become for the primary key. Because we want to identify, uniquely identify each row Yeah, we are using for the primary key. Okay, then easy to search that particular record also. Therefore, we are using primary key. Table relationship. The line that connect the data table in the database diagram shown earlier display the relationship between the tables. Okay, you can make. The infinity sign is the many relationship, and other one is the one to many. Okay, at the end of the each line indicate one to many relationship. Okay, already you study in the database design in your data ER diagram in your database. The relationship is the one to one, no one to many, no any more many to many relationship. If you add the many to many relationship, that is the random data is there. Therefore, we want to make for the one to many or one to one relationship the data base. Okay, that is the you are making for the normalization. Come for the make for the one to one or one to many relationship the each tables. For example, customer table has one to many relationship with the order table, and each customer can place many order. One customer can place many order and one to many relationship between the order and order details. One customer can make many order. Then one to many relationship between the product and order detail, because one order has many product. Okay, then the each product can appear in many order detail also. Okay, one order has many product also, many product, and one product also appear in the many order. Therefore, we use that is another table as order details. We break it the that relationship, because if you have that here, you can see one product and order detail order. Okay, one product can appear in many order details. Many order. Then we create that make the break. Now is the foreign key. One to many relationship are modeled using foreign keys. Okay. For example, order table has the column name as a customer ID. That's the foreign key of the that particular table. Customer ID is the foreign key of the order table, but the customer ID is the primary key of the customer table. If you have particular attribute is a primary key, then you can use for the foreign key for other table. Other table. The column is related to the customer ID column in the customer table through a foreign key. This means that every row in the order table must have the correspond row in the customer table with a matching value for the customer ID column. Okay, matching with the customer ID. Since the relationship between the customer and order table one to many, this means that there are many rows in the order table with the same customer ID also. One customer can make many order. That's the mean for the one customer can many order. Then one order has many products. Okay. Conceptually, you can think of the foreign key as a pointer from the order table to customer table. Order table to customer table. Okay. I will explain how to create that relationship, everything. It also parent table and child table. The table contain the foreign keys known as the child table. Okay, and the table with the column referenced by the foreign key is known as the parent table. Okay, then primary keys. For example, the primary key is there. That column is used to another table as a foreign key. then parent table is where the primary key is there in that table. Child table is that column, that field attribute in the foreign key in that other table, that's a child table. Now you can see, for example, order table is the child table and customer table is the parent table. We are consider for the customer ID is the foreign key of the order table. Therefore, that is the customer table is the primary is a parent table. Order table is the child table. Okay, then we use the foreign key and primary key relationship is as a parent-child relationship. Parent-child relationship. Okay, using Microsoft SQL Server. Login. Click NordVPN database table. Select customer. Table right click. Select design. Okay, you can go to that select customer table and right click and select design. Then click the table designer to menu and click relationship. Then you can make the relationship. Okay, see the relationship between the customer and order. You can see what are the relationship there. Okay, click the NordVPN database table, select customer and right click and select the design. If you now you are the design view, click the table designer on the menu, main menu, table designer relationship. You can see the what is the thing. Then you can go there. Okay. Database. What is the table? Customer table. Right click design. Okay. The table designer. Relationship. Then you can see. Okay, that's a foreign key. Okay, in the order customer, name of the relationship. Okay, order customer. Later also I will explain how to make the relationship also. Okay, in this table, this is the primary key, you can see. Okay, you can set the primary key. Here this is a key. If you want to create other key also, you can click here, you can make the primary key. If you want both, you can select, use a chip key. Okay, now you can select this another primary keys also. Okay, this is the data type. Later we will study for the what is the data type also. Only need that database type also. Important. Okay. Now I explain that in this NordVPN data diagram. Okay, new database diagram. What are the table want at for the relationship? Okay, we can see the four table already use the database. Okay, product, order detail, orders, customer. Products, order details, order, customer. Then we want to add the four table. Products. Customers, order. Okay, you can select with the okay control key. You can select many table also. That's the way. Add. Okay, already relationship there. Okay, already relationship there. Already create the relationship there. Just I add the database, sorry, tables. Wait, I want to reduce the size of the table by table size is long. Okay, I will reduce later also. Okay. Now you can see the relationship. Okay, you can select. You can delete the relationship here also. Yes. Now you can track product IDs there. You can make. Okay, this is the way you can make the relationship. Okay, I will explain later. Here you can track. Okay, now you only select in the product table. Product ID is a primary key. In the order detail table, product ID is a foreign key. Okay, if you have another key also, you can select here. Now you can okay already is there. Okay. Now you can see this is the select the relationship. This is the relationship name. Okay, this. Okay. This is the way also you can. At the table, you can make the relationship. Okay, then okay, otherwise you can make the relationship again also. Here is the name of the relationship. Order will be coming for the foreign key, order detail and product. Sorry. It's okay. Order detail product as this, like in order details, order table. Okay, this is a many, one to many, because one product has a many, sorry, one order detail has a many product. Okay, then one product also can make, okay, many order details also there. Okay, many details are there. Then we make this. Okay. Now these are the foreign primary keys. Both are primary key. But here is the customer ID here. Order and customer ID. But the customer ID here is a foreign key, not in the primary key, because one customer can make many order. Okay, but the order is the no duplicate. One order belong to one customer. One order belong to only one customer, not in the many customer. That's order ID is one ID is there. For example, you can now you follow the course. Then one student can follow the one course in university. Course mean that's a BTech in ICT. There's a network or something. One course. But one course can follow many students. But one student can follow one course. One course. But one course can follow many students. Okay, then the course has many students. That's like here is the one customer can make many order, but the one order belong to one customer. That's a one to many, let's say one to many. Okay, then you understand the primary keys, why you need for the primary key and foreign key. Without primary key, you cannot make the relationship with the other table. It is there. Okay, now you can see what is the relationship with the customer and order. You can make how to relationship also. Now you can see, okay, I will explain again also the table designer relationship. Now also here you can see which order details. Okay, this has the, everything has the relationship. Order details, order, order customer, order employees, order, it has that order table. Okay, order table has a many relationship with the other table also. Now you can see here is a two relationship. One is order detail and customer. Okay, order has a order detail, but the order also has a employee and order shipping also. I didn't attach here, sorry, add the table in the diagram. If you add that diagram, you can see the thing. But it has this relationship. Then that relationship you can edit. You select the particular relationship. Table, click here. Table and column specification. That is here is the relation. Then you can make them your own name also, relationship name. Order customer relationship. Okay. For example, I select this employee order, table and column specification. Click this explore. Then you can hear employee. The employee table, employee ID. Order has a employee ID also. You can see there the order has a employee ID. Foreign key here. They have a relationship. Okay, now is the null values. The database must be all, must also provide the ability to handle the value that are not set or are otherwise unknown. If you are unknown, then you can give for the none mean is nothing. It's not the zero, empty. That's a nothing. Okay, null value is the unknown. If you unknown that thing, then you can use the null value. For example, we want to collect some data from students. Okay, we ask for the your data birth or something. But some people like to give their data birth. Or for example, for salary. Some students are working or some staffs are working, then we want to ask for the salary. Some student, some staff unlike to give the salary detail. Therefore, you want to make for that's a null. If you not null, you had to provide the any data, the proper data, specific data you had to give. Therefore, we use the null value. Okay, sometimes you are unable to get some value. Therefore, we can keep it as a null. This unknown value are called null values, and a column is defined as along, okay, allowing or disallow null value. When column allow null values, that column is defined as a null. Otherwise, is defined as a not null. Then a not null column is row must always have value store in it. Okay, you had to provide always, you must provide the values. Otherwise, you cannot create the new rows. Already you familiar in the access. If you make the not null value for a particular column, you must pass any the proper, okay, specific value. Specific means the related data type values. Then you write. If you write to add the row but didn't supply a value to not null column, then the database would display the error. Okay, would not add your new row. You can't add the new rows. That's a null. Okay, some important data I want to collect. Important, sorry, data. Then you want to, you must assign that column is a not null because that data is need. For example, in your here, we want to take your attendance or something. Then we need for the your registration number. Then particular column as a registration number or something, then this is a not null. You want to assign. Okay, these are the things you want to consider if you design the database. Design means now we are going to create the database, develop. Already you study for the database design. Now you that stay. Okay, sorry. Now you can see that is a you want to set that not null. Okay, now you say index. An index for the database table is similar in concept to book index. Okay, if you have some books, then the book has an index. Okay, the backside. Okay, last page, the backside is they have an index. What is the purpose we are using the index for the books? You quickly find some pages or some details. Therefore, we use for the index. Same thing here also. Okay, you have quickly you can find that index. Okay, you have some doubt or something in the book and any theory or something, then you can see the index. Okay, this page is explained that like this. Related for that one, then you can quickly you can for that page. Otherwise, you want to check the chapter wise or something. Every page you want to see. Okay, church and left. The index is the database table is similar in concept to a book index, except that database index are used to find specific row in table. The downside of the index is that when the row is added to the table, additional time to require to update the index for new row. Then if you give the index, you can easy to find that particular row. Therefore, we give the index. Okay, you can set the particular column. Okay, set the index and that you can use that column as a search field. Search. For example, yeah, if you the bank, if you ask that my want to check my account balance or something, first they ask for the account number, after they ask for the your ID card number. Exam board meeting. Update the index for the new row. Okay, then easy. Then they are that bank also ask for the thing because they confirm. Or easy to search your record also. Generally, you should only create index on the column when you find that you are retrieving the small number of rows from the table containing the many rows. Okay, you have the many rows something, but you want to get the small number of rows. Therefore, you use the index. The good rule of thumb is that an index is useful when you expect any single query to retrieve the 10% or less of the total row in the table. Okay, then you can use that. This means that the candidate columns for index should be used to store a wide range of values. A good candidate for indexing would be a column containing a unique number for each record, while a poor candidate for indexing would be a column that contains only a small range of the numerical code 1, 2, 3, like. Okay, then you can assign the index also. Okay, this administrator is responsible for the create the index, because that people who are the developer, they respond for the create the index. But an application developer, you probably know more about your application than the database administrator, and will be able to recommend which column are good candidate for the index. Okay, which column for good for indexing. Then you can decide, because now you are the developer, application developer. Then you can decide. The managing index using SQL Server Management Studio. How to manage? Select table, right click, design. Okay, then you can as a design mode. Go to the table designer in the main menu. Click on table designer, select index and keys. Okay, you can set the select designer, table designer, and there. Okay. Okay, or for example, customer table design, table designer, index and key. Here you can set what is the city. Okay, already as a thing. Then you can think about you want to add is the name of the index name. X customer something. Okay, now you can select the which column want to add. Okay, specific column, you can select the what is the column make the index. Okay, now you want to make for the fax number, want to index, you can select. Okay, now is the this the thing, then you can make this as the index. X customer, like if you want unwanted that index, then you can delete, select particular thing, delete. If you add, it's come here. Then name also here. Now I want to make this index as a fax. Okay. This is the name of the index. Okay, it is always create. That's a IX underscore customer. That's a customer. That's a name of the table. Now we can with a fax index. The name of the index. Okay. Sometimes want to search some customer also fax number. That's like you want to set that. Index. Okay, any column you can assign the index, but if you have primary key of the table, it's automatically assigned as the index column. Okay, index column. Okay, now we come for the column type. Now is the data type. Each column has, you can set the type. Now we want to consider that also. Now we have the different data type. Now you can see the all integers are there. We have here is the four types are there. Then you want to know is the integer value from 2 to the power 63. Like, okay, this is the amount. Then we need for the big int of integer value, this amount, then you can assign both that particular column as a this int. Small int, integer from 2015 minus 32,000 something to plus 32,760. Okay, only you can assign this larger value. More than that, you can assign this int. Because if you allocate, okay, if you assign the data type, then computer allocate for the, that data amount to particular row or particular, sorry, particular column, that value, want to allocate. Therefore, you want to think. Now, this is the tiny, okay, tiny, okay, tiny int as integer value 0 to 255. For example, you want to keep it that IP address. Already you are familiar for the IP address. Then that range is 0 to 255. Then we want to assign the four column for that, or three column like, then like. Or sometime you want to keep it the color values, RGB. Already you are familiar for RGB. That's a red, green, blue. That value also 0 to, you want to mix up color, some application or something. Then you can use for the, this integer value, 0 to 255, then tiny int. That's a data type. Bit 0 or 1. Yes, sometimes we are using for the some question, yes or no. Are you female or male? Yes or no. That's question like. Then we can keep it as a 0 or 1. Then we can use the bit, that a data type. Decimal, numeric, that's money. Okay, you are going to keep it the value as a money, currency, money, money. Then you can, okay, then you can learn this one. What are the suitable for particular column data type? Then you can select and create the table. Okay, already you study in the previous semester also, but now also I again, because if you said that is a big int, but okay, big int, but you are only used for this 0 to 255, then computer allocate the memory. Okay, we won't need that memory for the integer big int. That's a, this amount of memory, like then won't keep it that memory, reserve the memory. That's the way. Then you can use the thing. Then you can use this 0 to 255. You can avoid the error also. For you want to keep it that one column for the red values, then you want to must enter 0 to 255. If you make, okay, enter the more than that, like, then it is, if you assign this data type, not allowed to more than 255. Okay, that's like, now you can see that if you enter the IP address network, IP address, they are not allowed for the more than that, like 250 maximum, 255. That's like, okay, this is the data type. Very, I didn't, okay, explain everything. You can read and follow that what are the data type is suitable for your table, particular column. Okay, we are calling, using for the column like, that's attribute. Each column in the table has a specific data base type. Okay, investigate the following data type, data table in NodeWin data base, cursor table, product table, order detail table. Okay, already we discussed. Then building the queries. Find the order ID placed by the customer, particular customer. Okay, I didn't do that, but you can do, and next class I will ask any problem is there. Okay, because pick one order ID and find out the product and quantity order. Okay. Then you can find. Then you can want to write the queries. Find the order ID, place in the customer ID as this line. Okay, in the order table. Okay, then select asterisk mark all attribute want to retrieve, attribute value want to retrieve, then you can use a asterisk mark. Otherwise, the particular attribute won't need, then like from order table. Okay, order table, and where customer ID equal ALFKI. This is the customer name, customer ID equal that like. Then it is display for the particular customer. How many orders are me? Pick one order ID and find out the product and quantity order. Okay, particular ID and what are the product order. Okay, then you can go for the order details. Because the product ID is in the order details. But we need for the okay, order ID also there. Then we can use for the product detail table. Order ID, sorry, for select asterisk mark from order detail table. The table name as order details. Where particular order ID. Pick one order ID, then you can find that. Then we can get for the what is the products are there and quantity order. Now we want to create the table. Okay, we want to create the one table in a database. Okay, Northwind database. That is a name as a table name as a person. Okay, these are the attributes. Employee ID, first name, last name, date of birth, fee address, and employee ID. Okay, already employee ID is there. Sorry, employee table is there. That table consists the employee ID. Then here you can see here that you must give the same data type. Otherwise, you cannot create the relationship with the person to employee. Person to employee table. Incha number of character. The length also 5. It match with the same thing. Okay, you can see there. Open that data SQL server. Employee. Okay, I won't. Okay. Now, persons also there. Already that table is there. I want to remove. Okay, design. Okay, but already there. But we want to make the relationship. We want to check for the ID. But the employee ID is the integer type. Then we want to give the same integer type. Otherwise, we cannot make the relationship. We can't make the relationship also. Okay, that is an important thing. But anyway, we create that later also we can change. Okay, want to create that this table. Okay, we can create the two way. Okay, manually also we can create, otherwise we want to write the SQL statement. Okay, if you write the SQL statement, sometimes take the long time. We can easy to create the table in manually. okay, in manually also. The table. I click new table. There's a column name you can type. After later we can serve the table name. Okay. Select this table folder, right click new table. Okay, now is a table designer. We can write now is a what is that table we want to create? The person, personal, a person ID. Type the person ID. What's the data type? Integer type. Okay. You can type I int. Okay, it's come. It's not null because that is we are going to set for the primary key. Okay, now first name, last name as a in vacha. Okay, number of vacha. First name. Okay, in vacha. Then how many character? 15. You can set last name. Then date of birth. Okay. Okay, these are the we need for the all column, therefore not null. Hello, null, no. But date of birth is hello, null, and address also yes, but employee ID, no. Employee ID is need. Okay, date of birth, P address. Okay, we are using DOB like something. Okay, so anything. But you can set here is the date and time. DDD. Okay. Allow to that like P address, person address. Okay. If you think about not enough, like you can make the how many characters need. And employee ID. Right. Okay, in vacha 5. But that's a not null. Now we want to. This is the primary key. Okay, you can select that particular column. Select here is a set as a primary key. Okay, person ID is the primary key. Now already I have the name of the same table name. I want to delete. We cannot create. When same name is there, duplicate. I already mentioned duplicate object cannot create in here. Okay, now you can serve. Serve table. It's okay. Serve table, we can give the name. Persons or something. Okay. Okay. Oh, already exit. Okay, refresh again. Wait. Wait a minute. Okay, I refresh. Okay, I want to refresh that database. I already delete, but that is not happen in the memories. Okay. Okay, already that name particular table is yeah, we cannot create the same name. Table DB already exists. Let's delete it. Hey, refresh my. Okay, this also. Refresh. Name is come. There's a person. Okay, this is the way you can create. Okay, this is the way you can create of the table. Create a table using SQL Server Management Studio. Lock in the MSQL Server Management Studio. Select the particular database. Select the table. Right click and new table. Type this one. Like. Okay, this is the detail of the data type. All column data type details. Okay, then you can serve. We can set the primary key also. As a person, ID is the primary keys. Already explain it. Set the permission. Okay, set the permission. Select the person table in the Northwind database. Right click, go to the properties. Okay, select permission. Click search. Click browser button and select the public. Grant what other public can do this table. Select insert, update and delete permission to the public role. Okay, public user can select insert, update and delete. This you can, the particular person granted permission, then they can do it. Okay, then you go to the select the person table, Northwind, right click, go to the properties, select permission, click search, click browse button and select public. Okay, browse button. Select the public. Public can select insert update. Okay. Some table public can insert. They cannot update. That like you can give the permission. Okay. They can select insert, but they cannot update and delete. Okay. They can insert. They cannot update and delete. That like you can give the permission the role. Go there, person table, right click, properties. Okay, permission. Okay, that's search. This browse, we as a public, guest user also there, public also you can grant. Okay, now you can select what are the things you can grant, what are things you can deny. Okay, you can see this dialog box. They can alter. Alter mean edit or delete, insert, select. Then you can, this is a grant. Alter. Okay, they cannot delete, therefore you can deny. In it. They cannot delete. They can insert. Okay, they can update. That's like you can give for the permission. Because you are going to create, okay, develop the database program, database with the database program. Then you can give the permission. Okay, this is also important. For example, we are conduct the exam. Then I can give for the your marks that they are have the data entry operators. They can enter the marks. Okay. If you have some problem or sorry error, only exam head he can update or edit. Only permission for him. Then that is a control is there. They are also control. Only that particular person can edit. In the bank also, only particular counter people can deduct your money and update your money instead. Okay, or update your money. Other person cannot do it. That's a need the permission. Okay. Now you have a account holder for a particular bank. You want to cancel your account. Okay. You want to close the account. Only particular person can close the account. Not in the old staff. Hello. Then this here we can give the permission. It is important for in your database design. Okay. Then okay. If now we say allow for the particular public and edit something like or guest user. Okay, we have a different here. We can make the any permission. Select the table properties. Okay, this is a thing. Now is a schema. This is the our who is the owner. Is a DBO. Is the owner of the database. Create this database. The table. Okay, search. Okay, browse. Public. Already public has the role is here, database role. Or the user also you can add. Okay. Now is the public here, database role is there. And now okay, you can create. This is the way you make the permission. Okay, public role. Create the relationship. Select the person table. Relationship in the toolbar. Select the table and column specification. And employee ID. You can make the thing. You notice that relationship name is automatically come for the table. Okay. The creating index. Already I explained how to create the index. Okay, now I skip this one also. Okay, in the table design menu, you can go there, index, add new index, and something you can use that. Okay, create constraint. A constraint allows you to define the limit on the value that may be shown in the column. You will be create the constraint on the date of birth column of your personal table. Okay, date of birth, you can create the constraint. Okay, this constraint will be ensure you can place only date between January 1st, 1995 and December 31st. Okay, after this thing, I will another 10 minutes. I will finish my lectures. Then next week we can continue another 10 minutes. If we terminate, okay, don't join it again. Okay, you don't join it again. That's okay. This constraint will be ensure that you can place only date and between January to that line. Okay, for example, some organization want to recruit some people for the age limit they want to leave. Okay, age, this particular age person want to need, then you can give for the date of birth is the January 1st 1995 to December 31st 1990. Okay, particular age person want to need for particular tax or something, then you can create the one table or form something, then you can give for this constraint value. Then only particular person, okay, the particular person is born 1st January 1919, between that range, then they can enter. If you enter the other date, is reject. Therefore, this purpose we can give the constraint. Okay, some place want to recruit the people. Okay, some bank, they are give the age range below 25. Then they can give for this constraint for the date of birth. Only they need for that below 25 employee. Okay, rainy or something. Some person rainy. Then they can give for that. Okay. Then select the person table, click manage check constraint, add constraint, name is the CK, date of birth person or something, you can give the specific name, add constraint name. Okay, after that you want to set the constraint expression as follow, date of birth. Okay, that's a date of birth, it's a this range between date of birth greater than or equal this line and date of birth less than or equal this. Okay, then you can set that like only you can add the data between this range of the person. Okay, this is the purpose we need this. Okay, use for the constraint age limit. For example, you are already A-level students are there, you are the 2019, then you sit the 2018 exam, then we can put the constraint, exam sit dates, results, 2018 only. We are not considered for the other age, year results, only 2018, based on the selection. Then we make that the constraint as a exam date, sit day, year is a 2018. If you enter other thing, all are rejected. Then we can easy to short out your application. That's the way we mean. Okay. That's the purpose and we are studying these things. Okay. If you create something, then you follow, you can use some features for this life. Okay, next we start for the structure query language next class. Now stop. Okay, now we can go there. Constraint person table, you select that date of birth. Okay, table check constraint. At person, okay, you can select which you can give the expression here, identity person table design. Yes. Okay, we want to type that one. Okay, add the constraint, name as a sin something, and we want to add this one. Okay, date of birth greater than something, because this is the date range. Here, validate. Do you want to? Description. Sorry, description. Okay, now that is a constraint in the that table. Oh, date of birth, date and time column. Then you only enter for particular range age people. Okay, this is the only one age group, but you can give the range of age. Okay, okay students, the next class, Wednesday we will meet again.